organism, that is multicellular organism, starts their life from a single cell called zygote. So zygote is a fertilized egg, which is a result of the fertilization of male and female gametes. Zygote. So all multicellular organisms start their life from zygote. Right. Now let's see much more about a unicellular organism. We are talking about unicellular organisms now. And that unicellular organism is amoeba. Amoeba. Wow. Amazing. This is the only the most popular unicellular organism, which it can do all its activities on its own. It's a full-fledged organism, right? Unicellular. So amoeba. So how do you think amoeba looks like? Amoeba, it's like a irregular shape, or you can say a color daubed somewhere, or like a stain. So it has an irregular shape. So this is all about the structure of amoeba. Now amoeba consists of a nucleus. The amoeba can reproduce, multiply, divide, eat, digest everything on its own. So it has a nucleus. So this is called a nucleus. We will learn about it further. Now amoeba. So how do you think amoeba travels? It has only singles. It is a single cellular or unicellular organism. So amoeba has only one cell. So how it means that it has no legs, foot, or hands, palms. So how do you think amoeba travels? So amoeba travels with the help of pseudopodia. So pseudopodia. Pseudopodia is the false feet. Pseudo means false and podia means limbs. So pseudopodia means false limbs. So amoeba travels with false limbs or pseudopodia. Right. So what happens, like see, it also has, so these all are pseudopodias. Right. Now amoeba has many vacuoles, like so. These are the food vacuoles. There are many vacuoles, but I'm talking about food vacuoles only. So this is the food vacuoles, right? And then amoeba also has this membrane, right? That is cell membrane of our amoeba. So this is called a cell membrane. Now, what happens is that if amoeba sees an foreign particle, so for example, here is an organism here, right? Now, and amoeba wants to engulf it. So amoeba do not eat, it engulfs the food, right? So amoeba want to engulf it. So what happens? The fall feet start changing their shapes, like they will project themselves. So this, their membrane will change, then they will like this. They will try to cover the foreign particle like this. And when the foreign particle is inside the cell membrane of amoeba, the cell membrane engulfs it. And the process of engulfing food of amoeba, is known as phagocytosis. Phagocytosis. So this is the process of engulfing food by amoeba, right? So this is all the info about amoeba. So as we know, or it is the fact that an egg is a single cell. So an egg is a single cell. So if I ask you, what is the largest cell of the world? Right, largest cell of the world. So as we know, the cell is a single, the egg is a single cell. It means the largest egg will be the largest cell, and the largest egg is ostrich egg. So it means that largest cell is ostrich egg. Right, now smallest cell. It is possible that the smallest cell can be discovered as well, but the smallest cell discovered till today, talking about till today, is PPLO or mycoplasma. Right, PPLO or mycoplasma. So this is largest cell is ostrich egg and smallest cell is PPLO or mycoplasma. So I want to tell you one thing more. You all know about WBCs, right? WBCs, white blood cells, protectors of our body from germs, right? So WBCs or WBC, white blood cell. So these cells help our body to protect from germs. So they also can change their shape, or it means that the shape of WBC is like this, much more like amoeba. But WBC or white blood cell is a cell, and amoeba is an organism, right? And if I talk about amoeba, it is a full-fledged organism. Why is it so? WBC is a cell and amoeba is an organism, though they have the same shape. So why is it so that WBC cell and amoeba is an organism? That is because the amoeba has ability to do all the function in a single cell, but the white blood cell is dependent on our body for its food, for its survival. So this is the difference between the amoeba, that is an organism, and white blood cell, that is a cell, right? So these both are present everywhere. Amoeba is usually found in pond waters and white blood cell is a part of our blood, right? So that's all for cell part 3. We will be coming back in another video on cell. Till then, please take care and please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Bye-bye. Meet you soon. We'll be right back.